Track 8, Goatell on the Mountain with Tonic Sulfa and Mally. All right, so this is an interesting thing. So Tonic Sulfa is a Minnesota-based a cappella group, and they've been around for 25 years maybe at this point? I don't even know. Something like that, 20, 25 years. And when Home Free was coming up through the ranks and, you know, learning our own way through the craft of a cappella, they were one of our idols for sure. You know, they were the group above us, and we were always seeing what they were doing and how they were doing it. And it was always nice talking with them whenever we got a chance to meet with them and just get ideas and stuff. So when I... Oh, let me back up. I get distracted with my own thoughts. On one of their albums way back in 2001, they did arrangement of Goatell on the Mountain that was basically this. And I loved it back then. This is my favorite track on their whole CD. And it wasn't even a Christmas album. They just did it. They just wanted to throw it on there for whatever reason. And so I was always been in touch with Greg, who's one of the guys in the band. And I said, Greg, let's do a track together for this Christmas album. Let's do a collaboration. He said, sure, it sounds great. It sounds fun. And I said, I want to do Go Tell the Mountain. I want to redo it. I want to take what you guys had done and, you know, re-envision it, reimagine it, add some of my own flavor and rearrange it a little bit. So we did that. I added a new introduction for it. And then I redid some of the harmonies throughout the verses. And I also split up the lead between myself and Sean, their lead singer. And then we started talking about adding a rap in the middle of the thing. And I actually worked out a whole rap myself. Oh, I should have performed it now. That would make sense. I don't know where it is.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that'd be cute. Maybe it'll be a special Patreon bonus at some point. I'll show you the rap that I had done. I think it was pretty good. But Mally is a local Minneapolis rapper who has worked with Tonic Sulfa before. And Greg said, you know, you should ask Mally if he wants to do it. I said, all right. So when Sean was recording his parts for this at a different studio, Mally was there as well for some reason. And I said, hey, Mally, you just want to write something, throw something on there? He said, sure. So he did it. And then when I heard it, I'm like, yeah, that's pretty good. Yeah,
pretty good.
Yeah, that fits the style better than what I was doing. Fine. So we'll have him do it. So that worked out pretty cool as well. And I love this arrangement. I love the track. And we were discussing the video options for this as well. This is another one I don't have the video for yet. And what I want to do, if you've seen my video for Natural, the Imagine Dragons song I just did this year, that one has got what we call a box video, where you just have you're singing yourself, and then you edit it around different boxes of people singing it. And that one has some really neat images and editing effects. And so I want to do that, I think, with this. So I'll get the six of us together one night or something to film that. I think it'll be a cool video, that kind of editing thing. So I'll hope to try to do it this year, but it didn't work out. Schedules did not align. But next year we're going to do it, make sure it happens, because I want to get a video for this. Yeah, the three songs I don't have videos for yet, I want to do by next year. That's the goal of this whole thing. Yeah, I mean, what did you think of this track? I mean, it's different, right? Completely unlike
you've
heard before.
Yeah, I love it. I love that it's different. It's unexpected and it's fun and I like it.
That's one of the challenges of Christmas music, to
yeah.
do different versions of these songs, because you've all heard them so many times in so many ways. So trying to do something different is always the goal and the challenge, which I love, though, too. I love taking something and trying to do a different approach on it. So go tell it in the mountain.
That's pretty much what you do with 7th Ave, right? Like you take
things
that exist and put a twist on them in some way.
Well said. Yeah, we try to, at least.
So.
That's the goal. Well, sometimes we do something. Like, Mary Did You Know was just a really nice arrangement of the song. We didn't really take it a different direction.
Yeah.
But yeah, I really try to do that with 7th Ave, for sure. So track 9 now is What Are You Doing New Year's Eve, which again, like track 7, was the jazz club set. Another one that I had originally done with Home Free. Again, this is an inspiration. Though for this one, I didn't take from much the original Home Free arrangement. I kind of went not a whole new way. We did it more traditional, not really paying attention to what I had done vocally before. And I had my little jazz combo again and just did the standard version of the song and just tried to sing it up real pervy-like. And I'm really happy with how it turned out. My graphic designer from Sweden, Johan, said it was his favorite track of the album. So I'll take it.
It's one of my faves. Maybe number 3. Maybe number
4.
I don't know.
Whoa.
We'll see. I'm not going to commit to that, but maybe.
How do you choose between so much greatness, right?
I also just really like that song. Like, it's very fun and cute. And like.
Oh, yeah, your favorite version was the Zoe Deschanel
and Joseph Gordon-Levitt, yeah.
Yeah, it's a great version. If you haven't seen that before, check it out. It's super cute. She just plays the ukulele and they sing it together.
Yeah, it's so cute.
So adorable. And they're so adorable. Oh, I hate them.
They're perfect.
Right? right? Yeah, so I just did the vocal jazz, or the jazz style, and with a little combo, and it's a nice little track. Oh, I like how it turned out. It was nice for this one and track 7. It's the same place, same band. We just changed our outfits between the videos to make them a little bit different.
Yeah.
Track 10, I Wonder As I Wander, featuring the super bass, Elliot Robinson. Now, you didn't even think it looked right, right? You didn't believe it was coming out of him.
It's like, what?
This guy is one of the best basses in the entire world. He legit is a beast. He's a monster. I've done several things with him before. He was on my Rise CD. He did Precious Lord Take My Hand With Me. He's also done at least a couple, and he's done 2 Seventh Ave tracks with us. When we do a cappella stuff, sometimes I want to bring Elliot on because he's so good. And this was originally a Home Free arrangement. I didn't arrange this one, actually. I got this from a guy named Nathaniel Adams, who was a pretty neat arranger in his own right. This was back in the day when we were doing Home Free Christmas CDs. And I said I wanted a version of the song, and he came up with this one. Really love it. It was fun redoing it all myself, because obviously the original Home Free version had the 5 people singing it, and this was all me with him on the Elliot on the bass killing it. For the video on this, I went to super simple just to see what would happen with this. Because I didn't have a good idea within a reasonable budget as to what we would do for this. So I was down in Dallas in July, actually. It was 100 degrees outside. Ugh. And I had my friend Melissa, who's my violin player I've done a couple videos with. And Elliot and I got dressed up, and we just went out to this sort of lakey area and just filmed us singing it to see how it would go. I mean, I could have done more with it probably, but yeah, it gets the job done, gets it out there. So that's all good. Although it was tough for Melissa because she'd never used my little camera stabilizer before, so she was very confused as to what was happening. Like, this is hard. but yeah, just Elliot and I just singing it. So for those of you who are watching this soon, still in 2018, it hasn't come out yet, but it'll be coming out in the next week or two in December, so you get to see that one. As well, the only Christmas video I did this year, actually. I've just been so focused on everything else with Seventh Ave, my piano CD, all those things. I just didn't have time to focus on Christmas videos. But we'll wrap it all up in the next year, like I said. So, I Wonder As I Wander, featuring super bass man Elliot Robinson. If you haven't checked it out yet, please do, because it's awesome. All right, track 11 is His Name Is Jesus. Now, this is an original number. This was written by a gal named Pam Schultz. Pam was, or is, a member of my old church in Mankato, where I spent many, many years in the church band, so we played together for quite a while. And she's always a very talented songwriter, and this is one of my favorite ones she had ever done. We would sing this one at Christmas quite often in the services. So as I was coming up with ideas and concepts for this album, I reached out to Pam and said, hey, I'd love to do one of your songs. And she said, oh, great, great, blah, blah. And then I figured out how I wanted to do it, so I got the guitar player. And then I have another good buddy of mine named Justin Knopfel, who is the guy who did You Raise Me Up by Viola Player, if you've seen that video on my channel. And we just did that one together, the three of us. And I also wanted to get my dancer. Her name is Marissa Starkey. And I've got some more things coming up with her soon as well, which I'm excited about. And she also was the gal who danced in Ashes, the Seventh Ave a cappella track we did this summer. So, got them all together, and we did this video in the Good Counsel Church in Mankato, which is the site of 2 of Home Free's biggest videos ever, O Holy Night and Angels We Have Heard on High. We did both of those there as well, so it was fun to go back there. And I did Crown With Many Crowns at this place. It's a beautiful church. I just want to keep going back there. And so, that's the setup for the song and the video. And I decided not to add harmony to this. I just wanted to sing it straight up to keep the production of it very, very simple. So it's just guitar, viola, and me, and then the dancer. And it's a lovely, lovely piece. And then Pam did a great job writing it, and my team did a great job putting it together and filming it. And yeah, love it.
Dancer is like mesmerizing in the video. Right? It's so good.
I love it when I get to combine art genres.
Yeah.
Be it dance or visual arts or whatever with the music. That's so fun, exciting, and satisfying for me. Love that. Yeah, it just felt perfect. And Marissa also is a member of the church in Mankato, so she knew Pam, and so it was really fun for her to be able to do that with us, for everyone involved.
That's such a cute story. I love that. The whole church came together and made a really nice video. That's beautiful.
So, track 12, the final track on the album, is Joy to the World, done in a very different style than what the traditional version of this song
Maybe
is.
Maybe this is my third favorite.
Oh, yeah, you did like the video.
Yeah, I did like the video a lot.
Yeah. So this was a 7th Ave track again. Originally, this was a Home Free track back on the original Home Free Christmas CDs, which are out of print, but you can still get them on Google Play, I think. Anyway. Generally, I went in a completely different style. I took the song into a minor key again, and I went with this sort of, like, James Bond guitar-y theme vibe for it, or a Wonder Woman sort of vibe with the that kind of soundtrack, just to go with a whole new direction, and I love how the song turned out. This was still with Kelly, when Kelly, Jacob was still singing her 7th Ave, so this was, 2 years ago it came out. And the video is awesome because I got a group called the Silhouettes, which is a shadow dance group. So they create all these different shapes with their dancing. And they filmed that in Colorado. I wasn't there. But they filmed that and sent it to us, and we filmed our stuff that in Minnesota here all together. And just a unique and different video. Visually very interesting with all the different shapes that they're creating. And then we put these little quotes all over there for being joyful, and then just a really cool song and arrangement of it, I thought. So, I think it's your third favorite now. So.
Yeah, I think it's my third favorite. So, sorry, what are you doing New Year's
Eve? Oh, well. So track 12, Joy to the World. If you haven't checked that one out, of course, check it out because it's so cool. And another one of the ones that I acapellized, or unacapellized, to take it back into instruments. It's a really fun new challenge to do that, because when I'm making these acapella arrangements in the first place, I'm sort of imitating horns or guitars or organs. So then to actually have real horns, guitars, and organs, it opens up a lot of sonic possibilities. So I really enjoy doing that. And I think I've hit now all of the old Home Free arrangements I had done that I wanted to do. So my next Christmas album, which will probably be the 7th Ave, will be all completely new stuff for me, which is fun too, to tread new ground and stuff. So. That is the album. A little more Christmas. If you hopefully you've enjoyed the album and enjoyed the discussions thereof for it. Thank you for Victoria for joining me and giving me someone to talk to. And
welcome.
Adding your 2 cents on how much you love everything. So it's
a good album. Yeah, I like it.
Your mom's liking it too, right?
My mom likes it too.
Sweet, so does mine. What a coincidence.
Wow. Our mom should talk.
They should. They'd be best friends. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. Check out all these videos and watch the remaining 3 that'll be coming out next year as well. And of course, stay tuned to everything else I've got going on because there's always stuff. And be sure to subscribe to my channel. So thanks for watching, guys. Until next time. Bye.